With it to J.P. Dumont, now McCarthy, who did well to catch that pass with way behind him. Now we're going to have a fight. Zmolek drops the gloves with Brantt Myhres. Myhres about the lone tough guy in the San Jose lineup. Wants a piece of Zmolek. They come together at center. Myhres with a left, swinging away. He tags Zmolek, and down they go. Zmolek tried to hang in there, but Myhres landed a powerhouse left.
It's kind of funny that Brantt Myhres was in the lineup tonight. One of the reasons he is because everyone around the league is wondering about the Blackhawks and all the talk about the preseason games that they did play in. Brantt Myhres was not in the lineup in their first game against the Calgary Flames. They've dressed what you would say a tougher lineup, if you could say San Jose has a tougher lineup. And Brantt Myhres right out of the top here comes up with Doug Zmolek. Now, if he wants to fight Doug Zmolek, he's not fighting one of the tougher guys in the Blackhawks. He did have maybe the upper hand on Zmolek and knocking him down with a bunch of lefts. But I don't know what that proves when you're going after a guy like Zmolek when you've got a bunch of other guys in red that he should fight.
I'll tell you one thing it's going to prove, I think, Billy, later on in this game for Lauren Mulligan's team. Brantt Myhres better keep his head up the rest of this game because that's a heavyweight going after a middleweight.
Yeah, absolutely.
Now the draw, Gary Suter. Meanwhile, Bob Probert just went over to Myhres, and Myhres wouldn't drop the glove. Remember, it was Myhres that went after the middleweight Zmolek earlier. Bob Probert just went right to him, and Myhres backed away. Now Janssens wants Myhres. Mark, I told you the Hawks weren't going to forget Myhres, and now Myhres and Janssens are trading lefts, and Myhres getting a couple in. Janssens trying to answer, and he does, and he stunned Myhres for a moment. After it looked like Myhres had the edge. Now they switch to the right, and Janssens with an uppercut got in. And I just had a feeling that Brantt Myhres wasn't going to be done with the fisticuffs in this game, because the Hawks weren't going to stand up, or they were going to stand up for their teammate and let Zmolek get taken advantage of.
Well, you mentioned, Pat, that Bob Probert challenged him first. He skated away. I was talking in intermission with somebody from the Sharks, and they stated that Bob Probert and Brantt Myhres two summers ago, when Bob Probert came to the Los Angeles area to work out and get into good physical condition, good shape, Brantt Myhres was also with them. So they felt that Brantt Myhres did not want to fight Probert because of the relationship, but obviously Probert went right at him and tried to start something, and Myhres skated away, so he went after Mark Janssens as the play developed, and they were wrapped up and along the boards. Bob Probert was there with Murray Craven, but Janssens and Myhres were the two combatants, both of them getting and landing a couple of terrific lefts.
Well, let's make clear, though, when you're telling that story about those two, it was Probert that went
absolutely
over. Myhres is the one that backed up on any part of it.
Yeah, no, you're right. I said that each. Probert challenged him right away, and he wanted no part of it.
With a left and connects. Ronnie Stern trying to land with a left. It doesn't appear to have connected. Now Janssens got another left and another, and Stern tries to answer. And quite a battle right in front of the penalty boxes between Janssens and Ronnie Stern.
This is the third combatant. It was Brad Brown, then Wendell Clark, and then Janssens for Stern.
And they aren't done yet as they wrestle at close quarters.
Wow.
And now Janssens got the right loose, trying to get to the back of the head of Stern. Oh, and a big left looked like it got in. Stern wants to try to throw the left-hand bomb if he can. Now he does, but he missed. And they have just exhausted one another. Oh, and Stern cut right on his forehead. Janssens opened him up. Oh, and Stern took a swing at Janssens, but hit the lines with Mike Civic instead.
This will be interesting.
Yes, it will. I would think that will be something that Colin Campbell will want to take a look at in the league office. Well, now Myhres and Brown have words. Clark in there as well. Manson had something to say to him as well. And the linesman able to step in between in time.
Well, the two guys fighting, Janssens and Stern, were broken up. They were away. The fight was over. And Ronnie Stern, instead of hit, I think obviously he was probably going to go to the dressing room and get a few stitches, but he skated back towards Janssens, who was at center ice with the linesman, and took a wild swing. Didn't come close to Janssens, but definitely did hit the linesman. And then after that fact, a little bit more talk at center ice. Brad Brown just punished Ronnie Stern up on the board with a hit. And Stern came up without a stick and went right to the face of Brown. And Brown trying to explain, hey, listen, that's a hit. Then Clark came in. Wendell Clark came in and ran over Stern. Brantt Myhres was on the ice. He came into Clark. And then all of a sudden, out of nowhere, Mark Janssens and Ron Stern were at center ice. And that was quite a battle. Brad Brown trying to time it perfectly. The puck coming around the boards. The linesman there, he just punished Ron Stern to the ice. And Stern was the player that came up without a stick and tried to get towards Brown. And at the end of the fight, well, not much of a punch, but it did hit the linesman in the right arm. Not close to Janssens. And that was when it was all over. So it looks like Ronnie Stern will get an extra 2 minutes. I'm not sure if he'll get a little added bonus in the minute department, but he will take a 2 minute minor into the dressing room, and the Hawks will have a power play.
Myhres gets a 10 minute misconduct. Janssens gets 2 for instigating, 5 for fighting, and 10. Ronnie Stern gets 2 for roughing, 2 for high sticking, 5 for fighting, and a game misconduct. So the extra minor to Stern will send the Hawks to the power play. And Ronnie Stern is done for this game. Here's Atchison moving over the line, shooting. Shields made the save. That was bowled over by Janssens. Shields takes exception, and he gave the waffle iron to Janssens. And we're going to have a problem now. Here's Brad Brown jumping in, and here comes Passmore from the other end of the ice. A big scrum in the San Jose end.
Pat, it was a 2-on-1, and Janssens was pushed from behind by, I believe, Gary Suter. He was trying to go through the top of the crease when the shot from Atchison was released. An exception to that did Steve Shields take. Steve Passmore with Alex Korliuk. I'm sure Alex Korliuk's not had a lot of fights in his career. Passmore having a little dance with him. Korliuk laughing.
Meanwhile, one of the Sharks has had all of his jersey and so forth falling out. Or taken off, I should say. And Passmore has had that look in his eye as if he wants to get one going here with Korliuk. And now Passmore got...
That's Myhres, I believe.
Punch, I think that is Myhres. And
yeah,
then here comes Janssens at Myhres. And... boy, there are square offs all over the ice. And the official just overmatched. Now Zmolek landed one on Marlowe. Then Zmolek got in another one on Marlowe with an uppercut. Then Korliuk comes in but doesn't know what to do when he gets there. And Zmolek's going to give him a problem. And now Zmolek has had his jersey pulled up over his head. He's going after Korliuk. The two goalies are going at it out in front of the benches. Now one of the Hawks reached over from the bench, Manson. You don't know where to look.
Oh,
and then Zmolek, did he just
took one, but he got him back.
He got Korliuk with a good one in the line.
Oh,
trying to tie them up. Henderson, he was just overmatched with the two combatants. Now the two goalies have separated.
And Steve Shields about twice the size of Steve Passmore. Korliuk actually landed one on Doug Zmolek, but fell in the process and then took a couple himself. Hawks bench talking to Steve Shields, and for some reason, the goalies got back together a little bit in front of the bench. Backup goaltender Mike Vernon talking to the linesman. Our referee referee Don Koharski about what happened around the bench area. He's right between them. Well, that hasn't happened very often as of late, Pat, having everybody go to it.
No, it's really a rarity now, no doubt about that. But from this game, there will be a few folks getting a short holiday from the league office, I think.
All goes back to a 2-on-1 Atchison with a puck on his off wing, fires it, and Gary Suter gives a little nudge to Mark Janssens, and Steve Shields is not in his crease. He's at the right of his crease trying to stop the shot. And then Shields didn't like it. Suter was in there to help Shields. Atchison come in, tried to handle Shields, and then it was just every shark. Brad Brown came flying in from way back. And Passmore from out of no man's land come flying in and pass no more. He was there.
The only thing I question about Steve Passmore, why would he take his headgear off on his way down the ice?
Yeah. Odd man situation for the San Jose Sharks, as Steve McCarthy was in the penalty box, so the man advantage definitely was in favor of the Sharks. And a little bit later on, there was a lot of talk going on. Kroliak didn't want any part of anyone, really, I think. And then Myhres got in and gave a little face rub to Passmore, and that shouldn't have happened. The linesman had him under control, but for some reason, the strength of Myhres was able to pull the linesman. And
I'll tell you, talk about strength, though. How about Mike Civic? Myhres, a big guy, and Mike Civic manhandled him.
Yeah.
Janssens coming to the aid of his goaltender, trying to get a shot in on Myhres.
That's dangerous. That skate slam, Gary Suter almost caught Myhres, and he also went down awkwardly.
Fighting does take it out of you, doesn't it?
Well, I don't know, but yeah, I think so. Especially as a goaltender. A lot of equipment on. Passmore, not a big man.
San Jose's first appearance in the United Center. Can you believe it? Will be the first game after the millennium.
Was
January
right?
The 2nd, yeah.
I believe the Hawks are back.
We're back in, here in December the 14th. Mm-hmm.
Well, it is 6-1. It is in favor of the San Jose Sharks. They have played a very good game. Got behind the eight ball very quick. Blackhawks just not able to get on track a little bit later on in the game after the two power play goals. Steve Shields and Steve Passmore both wrapped up. For some reason, Shields all of a sudden wanted to go with Passmore. They were just really hanging on to each other. They got tangled up around the benches. And that's when a little extra activity by the benches. Mike Ricci, Mike Vernon, Dave Manson were there.
Dave Manson reached it. Down Koharski saw that he was 5 feet from it. Manson didn't appear to do much, but he did reach over.
Yep.
And I think Troy Parchman might have done Manson a favor there, too, because the trainer grabbed
in the,
defenseman from behind, gave him the tug, try to keep him out of any bigger problem.
It'll take a long time to sort this out. Not sure how they'll do it. There's a couple situations you really got to look at. I think the Myhres situation coming across after he was being guided towards the penalty box and getting back into the situation at center ice with Kroliak and Passmore. A lot of debris here at the tank.
Well, the single referee is Don Koharski. He's talked things over with his linesman Mike Civic and Don Henderson. The whole thing started when the Hawks had a scoring chance and Mark Janssens crashing toward the net, hoping for a rebound. And you said it did appear that from behind he was cross-checked or pushed by Gary Suter, and that led him to make contact and solid contact with Steve Shields, who did his best Ed Belfour impersonation after that. He came up swinging with a waffle iron.
He certainly did, and that's a dangerous weapon. And remember, Shields, too, was not in his crease. He came out to challenge a shooter, probably knew that Janssens was going to be taken care of on the way down the ice, and Gary Suter, albeit behind Janssens, did give him a bit of a push. And that's when it all started. I would say that besides the fact that Myhres is on the ice, the San Jose Sharks didn't have a lot of aggressive players. Young Brad Stewart, Carl Yuck, Suter. They are on a power play. 36 seconds remaining in Steve McCarthy's penalty. So, as you mentioned, there could be a couple of situations occur with a few of the players on either side. Only a minute 15 remaining in the game. I think they'd be able to sort this out after the game, just play the last 1:15. And everybody that's on the ice should probably be off. And then go over it all after the game.
Daryl Sutter has just left the San Jose bench. He went back to the dressing room. I don't know if he's going back to check on somebody or maybe take a look at a video. But now Koharski is calling the captains over to explain to them what he's going to do. 5 minutes for charging,
wow,
to Mark Janssens.
That's an awful
in a game
call.
Misconduct.
Awful call.
Probert got a match penalty. Passmore got 2 minutes for leaving the crease.
Well, that's interesting. They saying that Proby was the guy on the bench?
Well, they got the wrong guy,
yeah.
I think,
yeah.
Unless we, certainly something could have happened that we didn't see.
Right. I don't agree with a 5 minute major to Mark Janssens for charging.
It did appear that he was pushed from behind by Gary Suter. I think the interpretation could be made that Janssens didn't make much of an effort to let up on the hit.
Yeah.
But I don't think he went in there totally on his own either.
No. And I think by watching the replay, the vantage point we had, he didn't have a lot of options. He was in tight. The shot comes from Atchinum, and Janssens is, as you mentioned, driving to the net. He's trying to get there to maybe get a rebound. And when he gets there, he's hooked from behind. It's Kroliak who gives a little bit of a push. And he's actually trying to come across, I think, in front of the goaltender and ends up colliding with Shields, who is outside of the crease. So not really a huge push, you would say, but I think trying to steer his own feet, put the brakes on and get out of the way, in a sense, maybe cut in front of Shields. And I don't know if his feet give out, but I wouldn't say he went charging into the goalie on purpose. But he has been given a 5 minute major for that. So the Blackhawks have a lot of numbers on their side of the board. 5 minute major, 5 minute major, and still 36 seconds remaining in the McCarthy penalty. But I'd say they got the brunt of the calls.